The petitioner has specifically stated on oath in paragraph 15 of the writ petition that he had no knowledge of the said FIR or pendency of any criminal case against him. Further, in para 17 of the writ petition, it has been stated that the petitioner was never arrested in the aforesaid case and he never applied for bail. The learned counsel for the petitioner has even argued to the extent that the petitioner was never present in the trial and it was on the behest of their persons named in the FIR that the case was contested in the trial court. As such, when the FIR was not lodged originally, he had no way of knowing about it unless it was investigated. He was never detained at the police station, never summoned for questions or arrested for interrogation. There was no way the petitioner could have known about the pendency of a criminal case. The counsel for the petitioner has further argued that even otherwise the said criminal case has arisen out of a cricket game being played casually in the locality. A dispute has arisen on the spur of the moment and it was a normal kind of scuffle which cannot be any indication about the character of a person being of criminal nature. After the game was over, the matter had been forgotten by everyone, including the petitioner, and he never imagined that an FIR will be lodged in such a small matter. In any case, there is no evidence on record to prove that he had knowledge about a criminal case being pending against him, and the information provided by him in the affidavit was absolutely true to the best of his knowledge and belief. Para. The learned standing counsel has filed a counter affidavit and has argued that since the information given in the affidavit was believed in the verification, hence the superintendent of police was justified in cancelling the examination. On careful examination of the counter affidavit, this court could not find any specific averments or material to prove that the petitioner had knowledge of the pendency of the criminal case against him. A rejoinder affidavit has also been filed reiterating the allegation and stating therein that there was no material before the superintendent of police, that the affidavit was deliberately filed in order to conceal some material fact or to mislead the authorities into getting extra marks for the filed purpose. This being the case, this court comes to the conclusion that on the date when the affidavit was filed, the petitioner was not knowing that the FIR was lodged against him. Moreover, on the date when the petitioner was sent for training, he already stood exonerated by the trial court on merits. The order of the trial court has been annexed by the learned counsel for the petitioner, and the operative portion of the order clearly exonerated the petitioner, including others, of the charges under which the trial has commenced. Over.